Thanks for joining us for CBN News Today. I'm Charlene Aaron.
And I'm Ephraim Graham. It might feel a little too early to be talking about congressional elections, but both parties are already gearing up for November. Polls show Republicans have a good chance to hold the House and to take back the Senate. While some point to a GOP advantage in the makeup of congressional districts, others say the White House could be hurting Democrats. Under President Obama, Democrats have turned out their base brilliantly for presidential elections. But in congressional elections, it's advantaged GOP, even as Obama was winning a second term in 2012.
In the House, Democratic candidates actually got 1.4 million more votes than their Republican opponents. However, Republicans maintained a 33-seat majority. And they did this because of the way congressional districts were drawn in a number of states.
But Republicans also have a big advantage in geography, especially in midterm elections, when the races get less attention. Looking at this map of U.S. counties in the 2008 presidential election, you would think that the red counties won by John McCain and Sarah Palin would have produced a landslide win over President Obama and Joe Biden, who won the blue counties. But it was the other way around. The Constitution calls for state legislatures to redraw congressional districts every 10 years after the census. So when the GOP won a big Tea Party victory in 2010, they took charge of the process.
In control of those state legislative chambers and the governorships in those states, you had a better opportunity to make sure you were drawing lines that were fair and competitive, and Republicans could do well heading into the 2012 elections and through the rest of the decade.
But the Democrats have helped Republicans with the gift that keeps on giving, the president's health care plan. 4 years ago, Obama helped the GOP win an historic 63 House seats and to oust Speaker Nancy Pelosi.
Well, it was the issue in 2010 that caused us to have the Tea Party revolution. It was all around the issue of health care, and this election is going to be all around the issue of health care, and they were two great elections
for
Republicans.
You've got congressional candidates. Mark, I don't know if you heard about this. There's a congressional candidate down in Alabama, I believe we reported on this, that is actually literally taking out a shotgun and shooting the Obamacare plan, the actual bill itself. Look, there's a lot of animosity towards this bill. That's not going to change anytime soon. And here's the key for Republicans. They would just need to stay out of the way at this point. Do no more damage.
Democrats still have time to make the elections about something other than Obamacare. But the party in power nearly always loses seats in the middle of a president's second term, and with voters convinced the country is going in the wrong direction, it is a steep hill for Democrats to climb.
Republicans hope to repeal and replace parts of Obamacare if they win enough votes this coming fall.
The National Security Agency has searched the communications of American citizens without obtaining warrants. National Intelligence Director James Clapper confirmed the practice in a letter to Congress this week. He didn't say when or how often the searches took place. The NSA gathers the communications of ordinary Americans, but it's not clear if those records had ever been searched. The Obama administration defended the practice because it says the communications were gathered legally. Civil rights groups say collecting and searching the information violates the Constitution.
More than 10 days after that deadly mudslide in Washington state, rescue crews are still searching for human remains. The death toll stands now at 28, but 20 people are still missing. But also, after better weather is coming, it's helping crews to advance their search.
The weather has been nice the last couple days. That has allowed us to get into more areas. Out there, as the water levels recede and more water's not coming into the sites. In the last several days, we've seen a total drop of 2.7 feet in the ponded areas throughout the site.
That said, as much as 3 inches of rain are expected beginning Thursday through Sunday. So far, the mudslide has caused an estimated $32 million in damage.
A powerful 8.2 magnitude earthquake struck off northern Chile Tuesday night, setting off a small tsunami. Five people died and more than 80,000 are without, out of their homes. Experts warn an even bigger quake could be on the way.
The quake struck about 8:46 p.m., triggering tsunami warnings and forcing evacuations along Chile's entire Pacific coast.
Everyone is staying up until super late, up on the mountains.
The shaking damaged several homes and businesses, as well as an airport. It also set off landslides that blocked roads and left thousands without power. Some 400 anti-riot police and soldiers have been deployed to prevent looting and to round up 300 inmates who escaped from a women's prison. At least 8 strong aftershocks followed the quake, shaking buildings as far away as Bolivia and Peru.
You could feel the wall moving as well as the floor. And there's a tent and a veranda back in the garden, and you could really see that moving back and forth.
The earthquake even triggered microscopic seismic measurements in New York's Central Park. Chile is located on the so-called Ring of Fire, an arc of volcanoes and fault lines circling the Pacific Basin that's prone to frequent earthquakes and volcanic eruptions.
We expect about another 8.8, 8.9 earthquake here sometime in the future. Could be tomorrow, could be in 50 years.
In 2010, about 500 people were killed when an 8.8 magnitude earthquake struck the country. In just the past 2 weeks, hundreds of earthquakes have been shaking Chile's far northern coast. Meanwhile, a small earthquake that hit Los Angeles last week could point to the big one. The U.S. Geological Survey estimates that a 7.5 magnitude quake there could kill 3,000 to 18,000 people and cause up to $250 billion in damages.
And Chilean authorities have canceled tsunami warnings for most coastal areas in the country.
Back here at home, the U.S. Congress has approved some much-needed help for Ukraine. Lawmakers sent a bill to the president Tuesday to provide $1 billion in loan guarantees to the cash-poor country. The move is also meant to punish Russia for its annexation of Crimea. NATO has also moved to end civilian and military cooperation with Russia, and its foreign ministers told leaders to quickly find ways to better protect countries who feel threatened by the Kremlin.
Palestinian leader Mahmoud Abbas dealt a big blow to Israeli-Palestinian negotiations Wednesday. He announced he would push for more UN recognition. Israel strongly objects to that move. The news prompted Secretary of State John Kerry to cancel plans to meet with Abbas. It also created doubts about a new deal to extend negotiations past the end of April. That deal involves the release of imprisoned American Jewish spy Jonathan Pollard. Kerry is trying to force Israel to release hundreds of Palestinian terrorists in exchange for the U.S. releasing Pollard. His ex-wife says she and Pollard are against that deal, but she fears for his health.
I pray that the Israeli government right now, that Bibi Netanyahu and his security cabinet will do all in its power to make sure that Jonathan is released now, because I am so afraid for his health right now.
It's a bittersweet feeling. We want to see Jonathan Pollard coming back home after 29 years in jail. But at the same time, we cannot accept this agreement. We cannot release hundreds of murderers who were convicted in murdering Jewish people.
Dannon says the release of Pollard is really a humanitarian issue, and it was cynical for John Kerry to link that issue with the release of terrorists.
British intelligence agencies are investigating the Muslim Brotherhood in the United Kingdom. That comes amid reports the radical group is now using London as a base after a crackdown on its activities in Egypt. After Mohamed Morsi was ousted as Egypt's president last year, Brotherhood followers launched a wave of deadly attacks on Egyptian police and military. Then Egypt's new government declared the Brotherhood a terrorist group. The Brotherhood has had a long presence in Britain, but the government is concerned the group has grown as members have fled Egypt.
Israel unveiled a recent discovery that has archaeologists marveling. It's a monastery dating back to the Byzantine period. Detailed mosaic floors provide a glimpse into what life was like in the region during that time. The excavation director calls the 1,400-year-old find spectacular and says the mosaics are unusual for that area. Detailed designs include inscriptions in Greek and Syriac. Researchers also found pottery, coins, and glass artifacts at the excavation site.
Coming up, are you frustrated with your bottom line? Help is just ahead. Rabbi Daniel Apin takes us to the original source, the Bible, for money-making tips.
Right?
They died when I was your age.
I saw him in heaven.
What if an ordinary boy?
Is this him?
That's Pop.
Your son had a near-death experience.
Discovered the answer to life's most extraordinary question.
Do you think my son went to heaven?
He told me everything was all right.
Based on the incredible true story.
We all want to be supportive.
I want to believe him.
But everything he talks about is impossible.
Will you believe?
You saw heaven?
It's beautiful.
Heaven is for real. See it this Easter. Rated PG.
Hi, I'm Wayne Allyn Root, former presidential candidate, conservative national media personality, best-selling author, and true blue patriot. I call what we're living in today the Great Depression II. More Americans now receive government entitlements than work full-time. The typical family earns less today than in 1989. I understand exactly what's happening to this economy and how you can protect yourself. So I sat down and taped a 30-minute DVD on the topic with all the critical steps needed to ensure Americans can both survive and thrive in 2014. It's called The Timeless Truth About Money. And it's only available in this special TV offer by calling the number below or by visiting online. Thanks to Swiss America, you'll finally understand the true goal of Obamacare, how our trillions of debt will sink the economy, and most importantly, why your golden years require a whole new golden strategy. Call now.
Start planning your journey to the Holy Land. Come to Jerusalem. Breathe the air Jesus breathed that very night in the Garden of Gethsemane. Walk in his footsteps to Golgotha. Step inside the tomb. See the stone where his body lay. Glory to God, he is risen. Ask your pastor or visit GoIsrael.com to learn more about making the journey that will transform your faith in God and his word. Experience Israel. You'll never be the same.
Inside every child is a hero, a leader, a friend to others, someone who helps out, who does the right thing, who dreams of what they can be, but they still need our help.
What should I do? What should I say? How should I feel?
That's where Superbook comes in. It provides moral and spiritual truths through situations children can relate to, teaching God's word to the children you love. Join the Superbook DVD Club and receive Superbook's newest episodes as they're available, plus two copies to share with others, all for your gift of only $25. Get Superbook today and watch the miracles happen.
Lawmakers in Mississippi are taking extra steps to protect religious freedom in the state. The House and Senate passed the Religious Freedom Restoration Act Tuesday. The bill says governments cannot put a substantial burden on religious practices. Some critics worry the proposed law could discriminate against gays and lesbians, but supporters say it's a victory for protecting First Amendment rights. The president of the Family Research Council applauded the measure, saying, "This common sense measure was a no-brainer for freedom, and like the federal law, it simply bars the government discrimination against the religious exercise." The bill will also add "In God We Trust" to the state seal.
Rabbi Daniel Lappin says you'll almost never find Jews tinkering with their cars on weekends or mowing their own lawns. He says there is a very good reason for that, and it lies within the business secrets of the Bible. Take a look.
Most everyone would like to have more wealth and prosperity. Few, however, manage to attain it. Rabbi Daniel Lappin is known as America's Rabbi. He says financial success is the result of doing the right things. In his new book, Business Secrets from the Bible, Rabbi Lappin uses simple concepts to help increase income regardless of your faith. It'll change the way you think about money and help you make more of it.
And I recently spoke with Rabbi Daniel Lappin and asked him what inspired him to write this new book.
It's perfectly obvious to anyone with eyes in their head that Jews are disproportionately good with money. And I really wanted this to be something that belongs to all of God's people. There's no reason why everybody shouldn't benefit. And the beauty of it all is that it's part of God's model. Mm-hmm. The more that people try to serve other people, the more money they make. And so we shouldn't love money, but we should love serving God's other children. Yeah. And what I do in the 40 secrets that I have condensed down from the Bible into this book is provide insight on everything, including how to apply for a job. I mean, people make the most critical errors when they interview for jobs, not realizing, just for instance, there are many examples, but just one of them is that they're focused on what they're going to get out of it instead of the service that they're going to bring.
Exactly.
And so it is in almost every area that everybody can benefit from, and we all benefit when people try and make more money.
What is the power of specialization, and how can an understanding of it increase your
wealth? Yes, one of the most common mistakes that we all make when we get an idea about trying to start a business is we come up with a concept and then we decide we're going to do everything ourselves. We're going to do the books, we're going to make the thing, we're going to sell the thing, and we don't realize that the biblical model is to create communication and connection and cooperation and collaboration and ultimately to be creative. Those are what I call the five C's. And so the Bible is a fantastic guide to building an organization, because if you just try and start your own little business in your garage, which I think everybody should be doing, there's no reason we should be confined to only one avenue of income, namely our day job, if you like. And there's a right way and many, many, many wrong ways to do that.
Now, you actually say that making money is a spiritual activity.
Sure. Yes, it absolutely is. Well, first of all, the key thing to understand about money is that it is not locked in to those little discs of metal that jangle in your purse or strips of colored paper or iron oxide molecules on the back of your credit card. Money is a symbol that you have served another human being. Because if you didn't steal that money or rob anybody for that money, somebody gave it to you voluntarily. And so we're very, very emphatic about understanding the spirituality of money, because the truth is that none of us can succeed at something which deep in our hearts we consider to be evil.
Excellent, Rabbi Daniel Lapin. The book is called Business Secrets from the Bible, and it's available where books are sold.
Oh, books everywhere. Also, I got a great website, youneedarabbi.com.
Oh.
It's a little self-serving, but...
but it works.
It works.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much indeed.
Excellent.
Coming up, you have heard that sticks and stones may break our bones, but words will never hurt us. Well, that's not really true. The life-changing power of positive words. It's coming up next.
Attention, sleep apnea patients. Are you tired of the expense and hassle of getting your CPAP and BiPAP supplies? Are you fed up with dealing with ill-fitting, leaking, or worn-out masks and straps? Are you worried about the effects that unsanitary tubes, cushions, and filters have on your health? If you said yes to any of these questions, Allied Medical Supply Network has the solution to your problems. You could qualify to have your supplies regularly delivered right to your door at little or no cost to you. That's right, no more inconvenience, no worn-out masks and straps, no more unsanitary equipment, just restful sleep. Call Allied Medical Supply Network today to determine if you may qualify to receive your fresh, brand-name supplies at little or no cost. Don't delay. Call us now to see if you are eligible to save money on regular delivery of your CPAP and BiPAP supplies. Call 1-800-815-9947. That's 1-800-815-9947. Or go to CPAPSupplyHelpline.com.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans, with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need, just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right, you could save up to 85% on your prescriptions, just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card, just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
They are the basic questions of life. Why are we here on this earth, and can one life really make a difference?
Well, one influential pastor says everyone has a divine fingerprint, and he told Paul Strand how to find out what your unique purpose is.
In an age of brutal recessions and college degrees that lead to no jobs, many young people drift, feel hopeless.
They've been disillusioned by their parents' marriage didn't work. They're disillusioned by a society that doesn't seem to be working.
Pastor Keith Kraft leads one of Texas's most youthful megachurches and one of the fastest growing. He says everyone can shake off disillusionment and drift, can replace them with a powerful, transformed life. This bodybuilding leader of Elevate Life Church in Frisco says it starts with realizing and totally accepting you are a one-of-a-kind creation of God, formed to do a unique mission on the earth. The same God who said, "Let there be light," and created a universe, also said, "Let there be you."
I believe every person has a deposit of God's glory that nobody's ever had, that nobody ever will.
He calls it your divine fingerprint, the title of his new book. Kraft points to Christ's words in John chapter 17.
The 22nd verse, it says, he says, "God, you've given me your glory, and now I give it to them."
If you'll do what it takes to live up to your God-given potential and purpose, Kraft says the world can be blessed by that unique glory in you.
Because through you, they'll see a part of God that nobody's ever seen.
But to get it out, you need positive words to communicate the glory.
Out of your heart flow the issues of life. And out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks.
One of Kraft's main points is that our life, our destiny, is shaped by our words, for good or bad, the ones we say inside our heads and to others. When you think about it, God, with a word, created worlds. And we, in a very real way, shape our world by our words.
Our words have that much power to form our world and to change our world. If you'll change your words, you can change your life.
As much as a judge condemns a criminal to prison, with words we can condemn our own lives or bless them.
Your life sentences sentence your life.
God sends powerful positive words and sentences our way every day. But Kraft tells his congregation and readers, the problem is we often block them and even our divine destiny with constant negative words, both thought and said. And that's easy when we can self-talk in our head 500 words a minute, many more than we can take in from the outside.
Through our words that never come out of our mouth, we shut down the words that we could be receiving that could change our life for the better. I call negativity the cancer of the spirit.
As he puts it, negative people negate themselves. So Kraft insists you must learn to block the negative and speak God-given positive sentences like the first ones he himself says every morning. This is the day the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
Our words give God something to work with, or our words give the devil something to work with. And that's why it's so important that we speak positive.
But there's much more to transforming your life and the world than just words. As Kraft and others at Elevate Life point out, you need to be intentional about your life, like intentionally honing your talents, because they're often a sign of what God put you on earth to do. You need to know what your core values are so you can live by a standard. You need to align yourself with people you can respect, love, and serve, and who will love you back. And it matters what you actually do day by day. At Elevate Life, they talk a lot about doing servant leadership. If you serve as a lifestyle, it leads others by your example how to live more godly, generous lives themselves. Or as Kraft might put it, you begin to elevate and transform the world around you.
When you're living in such a way that you create fallible excellence, that people say, I want to go where you're going because I see it evidenced in your life.
Intentional, generous serving also makes you valuable to others. And when people value you, they often throw open doors of opportunity for you. When the economy tanked, Kraft suggested to Elevate Life members losing their jobs that they volunteer to keep working in their workplaces for free till they find a new job.
And I'm telling you, it revolutionized some people's lives. There was one guy who was did that for 6 months, and his boss came back to him and said, I'm leaving this company and starting a new company. You're my first hire.
Kraft points out if you'll live to serve God and do good for others, they'll want to do good for you, and so will God.
Find a need and not fill it. Find a need and serve it. And if you'll do that, your greatness will be on display, not tuned to a station, WIIFM, what's in it for me, but you'll be doing things out of a heart to serve others. And you know what? God loves that, and He'll put His hand on your life.
Paul Strand, CBN News, reporting from Elevate Life in Frisco, Texas.
Do you have an idea for an invention or a new product? Brian and Alice Jagosh, the inventors of the Halftime Drill Driver, did. They invented a power drill attachment that lets you drill, flip, and drive in seconds. Brian and Alice licensed their invention to the company that brought you the Snuggie, and it's now selling in major retailers nationwide. Look for the Invent Help Caveman on the package. If you have an invention that you would like to try to patent and submit to companies for possible review and want free information on how InventHelp may be able to assist you, call now. InventHelp is America's largest inventor service company with sales offices in more than 60 cities nationwide. Call InventHelp today for free information. Our clients made a financial gain with their invention, but this is just their individual result. Brian and Alice's experience is not typical, as only a very small number of inventions are licensed or sold in stores.
For your free inventors information, call 1-800-559-8567. That's 1-800-559-8567.
If you had a choice between going bald and a full head of hair, which would you choose? Advances in medical science have resulted in the world's first and only permanent solution to hair loss.
Yes!
You wash it, you cut it. It's your own real naturally growing hair. When it comes to hair restoration, no one in the world has more experience than Bosley. The results look completely natural and are affordable on nearly any budget. But the entire process can't be explained in 60 brief seconds. So to find out more about this clinically proven and permanent solution to hair loss, call now to receive your free no obligation information kit. It'll answer all of your questions about hair loss and hair restoration. Plus, we'll also send you this $250 gift certificate just for calling. Every day you wait, you're losing more hair. So don't put it off any longer. You owe it to yourself to find out the facts. Choose hair. Choose Bosley.
Call 800-868-9957. That's 800-868-9957.
Hello? Is this thing on? Hey, kids. Do you love games? And do you love discovering things? Yeah! Well, do you? Yeah!
Then you're gonna love this. It's the new free Superbook Kids Bible app. You can play games, watch videos, find answers to your questions, and a whole lot more. The new Superbook Kids Bible app. Free downloads available on iTunes and Google Play now.
Finally, necessity is the mother of invention.
And students at Georgia Tech are working hard to invent and reinvent everyday household items to simplify everyday life.
So last semester, when we were sitting in senior design, we noticed that after the lecture, there was a lady that came in who had a baby and a toddler trying to get down the lecture hall stairs. And we saw this was a problem, so we thought, you know, there's our problem, let's go fix it.
Other inventions included snore-reducing sleepwear, a new way to learn how to play musical instruments, and one item that hasn't changed much in about 60 years, a revamped baby pacifier.
Additionally, our pacifier changes colors when infants have a fever, serving as a simple, intuitive way for mothers to know when their child is sick.
Georgia Tech holds the annual competition to encourage entrepreneurship and innovation among its undergraduates.
Wow.
Smart kids.
Revamp baby pacifier. Yeah. Wow, that's amazing.
As long as it keeps the child from crying. Let's do it again.
Let's do it again. Right. Well, that's going to do it for now on CBN News Today. You can find more of our exclusive coverage of the issues you care most about at cbnnews.com.
Take the time to tell us what you think about the stories you've seen here today. You can do that on Facebook or at CBN News on Twitter. Hope you join us again right here next time. Have a wonderful Wednesday, everybody.
Inside every child is a hero, a leader, a friend to others. Someone who helps out. Who does the right thing. Who dreams of what they can be. But they still need our help.
What should I do?
What should I say?
How should I feel?
That's where Superbook comes in. It provides moral and spiritual truths through situations children can relate to, teaching God's word to the children you love. Join the Superbook DVD Club and receive Superbook's newest episodes as they're available, plus two copies to share with others, all for your gift of only $25. Get Superbook today and watch the miracles happen.
Every day, people are connecting on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Now you can be part of the conversation and connect on topics you care about through 700 Club Interactive. Log on to Facebook, Twitter, or go to YouTube and share your opinions, your prayer requests, and your videos while making friends in our community.
Well, welcome to the show.
Join the conversation on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. 700 Club Interactive. Be a part of the show.